So welcome everyone to our career chat series with the College of Arts. My name is Elise Gertz and I'm the practicum and internship coordinator for the College of Arts. With us today, we have Spencer Huesken, and Spencer is a PhD student at Queen's University and a sessional instructor at the Department of Social, Cultural, and Media Studies at UFE. Spencer's research focuses on relationships between media, information, big data, the social processes of groups and organizations. Spencer also works as a quantitative analyst for Canadian Heritage and as a research associate in UFE's own Community Health and Social Innovation Hub. So welcome, Spencer. We're so happy to have you here today.
Great to be here. Thank you.
Yes, and interviewing him today is Dr. Linda Pardy. Dr. Pardy is the Associate Dean of Students for the College of Arts, where she encourages and supports faculty and students to recognize the embedded work-life career development that is fostered by humanities and social science education. Her research agenda is committed to ensuring liberal arts grads know they are equipped to tackle today's challenges and numerous career opportunities. So welcome to you both, and thanks for being here.
Thank you. Thanks for having us. So Spencer, tell me a little bit about sociology and being a PhD student and the whole journey. In a minute.
Okay, in a minute.
I'm just kidding.
Well, one of the cool things, actually, I did my undergrad at UFV. So my journey really started there. One of the great things about UFV, there's a breadth requirement in the undergrad. So you can really get your feet wet exploring courses across different disciplines. And I had a couple really great professors that brought me into the fold of sociology. And I quickly realized, well, this is the Swiss Army knife of disciplines here. There's nothing that I can't do with this.
That's cool. I just did an interview with Martha Dow, and she'd love the analogy of Swiss Army knife for sociology.
I'm surprised she hasn't taken it from me yet.
Huh. Well, there we go. It's, academic integrity.
Right.
There we go.
Shamelessly, I've lifted a lot of Martha's slogans myself. So mm-hmm.
There you go. That's trading, academic trading. So are you up for the 10 by 10 challenge?
Absolutely.
All right. So we're going to first talk about who were your early career influencers, mentors?
Well, I mean, I grew up in the Fraser Valley as a 90s kid. So pretty standard Western people that I look up to, rock stars, these sorts of folks. But in terms of formative influences and mentors, you actually just mentioned one of them. And I think the biggest three for me are in the SCMS department as Catherine Watson, Martha Dow, and Chantal Marler. I wouldn't be here today without them, and having taken their courses, they fundamentally changed my life.
Yeah, cool. And I think one of the things we know from career research is it's faculty that are the greatest influencers on people finding their path post-university. You know, as opposed to what we sometimes think of advising and counseling, which are great, but it is getting that one-on-one or those, you know, couple people, faculty that can spotlight your talents. So that's great that you had three people that you could rely on.
Absolutely.
So what makes you successful, makes you feel successful in your work? Like, when do you get to that moment when you think, hey, you know, I'm pretty good at this. This is making sense.
I think, okay, so this is a double-edged sword. In terms of my own research, I think I'm always questioning whether or not I am successful. I think that's one of the, you know, the traits of a self-deprecating academic is nothing is ever good enough. But on the other hand, when you're teaching, it's pretty easy to feel successful when you see students who are passionate about what they're writing about or topics that they really want to explore. I mean, it's a privileged space to be in where you get to watch people flourish constantly. So,
yeah, cool. What are the main factors in you picking a career choice? Like, have you thought about what you want to do after your PhD?
For me, you know, that's a tough one to answer because I think that I just enjoy learning. I think I'm an avid learner. So I'm always interested in so many different things, and sociology has allowed me to be interested in so many different things within the confines of a discipline. And I think for picking a career, in ways that I can just critically engage with other people and contribute to the world around us being a little bit better every day, I hope, as corny as that sounds.
It's not corny. And the thing that's really interesting about it is it's needed in so many areas, like not just education. It's needed in so many areas. And so it's a really important piece. What shapes your innovation skills or your way of thinking of new thoughts?
That's a good question as well. I think the biggest thing for me is growing up, I was also a musician. I still am. So I think in terms of innovation and thinking skills, I've been predisposed my whole life to out of the box thinking, improvisation, collaboration, all of the things that come along with, you know, playing music and making music. So that's, I think, one of the biggest factors in actually shaping my thinking. If that answers the question.
And this is kind of off topic a little bit, but we have been exploring kind of workplace innovation and what it takes and how do we teach towards workplace innovation. And what we're hearing a lot from students where they get their innovative skills or their from faculty is from their creative sides of their lives. Right. So the creative side of their life gives them the capacity to then apply it to something that might be a little bit more practical or a little bit more grounded in a job per se.
Absolutely.
But, so that's kind of a statement you could relate to.
Absolutely. And I think that, you know, one of the advantages that we have at UFV is our ability to engage and build relationships with our students. So I think that you can really draw that out in seminar settings. You can draw out those creative expressions.
That's cool. So what surprised you about your career today?
The first thing that surprised me was how much I learn from students when I'm teaching. So every semester, you know, you have an expectation if you're going to be teaching the same course in another semester that it's going to be similar, but each course, each section is entirely its own story. And every section, I learn so much from my students about myself and the broader society.
Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, in all the years I've taught, and it's a piece that I miss is that you learn something. And I think that leaves you as a good instructor too, when you're open to remaining to learning and shifting on the fly as you learn.
Absolutely.
Cool. So what did you play with as a kid? And how does it relate to what you do today?
Yeah, that would probably be, musical instruments, a lot of musical instruments. And I think as a small child, Lego was probably my favorite toy. And I think the thing about both of these is they're very open. They have open-ended scripts. So there's not necessarily a prescriptive method of how they ought to be employed. So again, I think that's just like another part of being creative. There was no, you know, clearly delineated thing that I ought to do. And you could just build and explore.
Have you brought Lego into your classroom?
No, but that might be a good...
I have three bins in my office.
That's excellent.
Yeah. And it's really fascinating to monitor the social reaction of bringing Lego into a classroom, because you've got some people that are just all in and ready to go, and others are reserved back, think, what is that doing in a university classroom? Like that. and that in itself brings dialogue.
Yes, absolutely. You know? That's genius.
The other funny part I've always liked is the Lego movie, the very first one.
Oh, I haven't seen it.
I use it a lot in teaching as well, because there's the creators who build the Lego with a pattern. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, the rule followers. And then there's the creatives that don't use a pattern.
Of course.
And the movie goes along and they actually find out that they both need each other in order to save the world.
Oh, that's
so
great.
The rule followers have nothing to solve, no innovation, because they can't create anything. And the creators can't get something done because they can't quite figure out how to onboard it. So it works for a really good movie about in class about talking about two types of groups. So you can bring your Lego to class.
I will.
So how do your personal values impact your work? Like, what do you believe in? And how do you thread that through your work?
Well, I think I'd carry this thread of creativity. And I think that valuing creativity and out of the box thinking, I think, is integral in studying sociology, because fundamentally we're trying to understand social processes and what makes society tick. And so a lot of the time you need to be able to have a very nuanced perspective on what social interaction is and what that means for individuals. So creativity, I'm going to use that one for that question.
Cool. Okay. What do you do when you get that feeling like, yes, this was good, this worked?
What do I do?
Like when do you get that feeling?
I think,
Or as a student, do you remember the first time you got that feeling?
Yes.
For watching it and for watching this career chat video, that's something intriguing for them because, you know, they kind of plod along and then you plod along as an undergrad student. And then all of a sudden something hits and you think, no, this is what I want. This is what I can do. Do you remember that?
Absolutely. I can remember the class that I took when I had that occurrence. And it was in one of Catherine Watson's fourth year seminars. And I remember, you know, we're studying intensive theoretical perspectives. And then suddenly when they start to stick and when you start to get it, you just see these patterns everywhere. So, you know, I was seeing the things that I was studying in the world around me all the time. And it really made sense to me, like, oh yeah, that's what's going on here. And I think that's probably the answer of, you know, when I feel that in the classroom, is I'll have students come up after class and talk to me and be like, oh, that topic we spoke about last week, I have this great example and this happened to me in my life. And just to see them get it and they light up is, it's great.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah. So when you think of a future, what do you dream of?
A day off, maybe.
I know. I know, it's felt that way, hasn't it? A day off and a day out would be nice.
Yes, true. Yeah, so I think, and the day out, I think, is very pertinent here because COVID's taught us a lot about the value of human connection. And I think moving forward, we have a lot of hard work to do to make the society that we live in a better place for everybody in it. My vision of a future, selfishly for me, is, you know, waking up and being excited for my day as I am right now. But I also want other people to feel that way. So whatever work we need to do to accomplish it, that's what we're here to do.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Okay. Final question. Describe a place that has an impact on you. Ooh. What was impactful?
I think the most, the place that I'll use for this is definitely my family's farm. I grew up on a dairy farm, and anytime I'm visiting my parents or I'm spending any time on the farm, I'm always reminded of, well, the value of hard work, but there's always so much life on a farm. There's mm-hmm. so much living, there's animals, and it's just, it's a deeply meditative place to be, really, for mm-hmm. me.
Yeah. Nice. Well, thank you for hanging out with us. And when we're back on campus, I want to walk by your classroom one day and see Lego.
Done deal.
Okay. Done deal. And you can borrow my Lego, so you don't have to trot it to campus. It's in bins in my office, you know. So.
Don't be surprised if I take you up on that.
Yeah. Sounds good. Okay. Thanks and have a good afternoon. Go out inside and play for just a bit.
Thank you.
Okay. Take care.